we say welcome to the Congo.
Yeah.
We greet you and we say welcome to the Congo.
Yeah.
Welcome to the African and the American, and this is Thomas here. She's the African.
And he's the American.
And I just want to cut in here and say my first time going to Congo was such a great experience. And as you can see in the videos, as we're driving down one of the main roads in Kinshasa, I was so surprised how much activity there was. I mean, people walking and driving, so many, and I was just amazed because you don't see that many people out on the roads anywhere, you know, in the USA that I've seen. And I was just wondering, like, where are they all going? You know, it was amazing to see all the hustle and bustle that was going on in Kinshasa. And so enjoy as you see the scenes of so many amazing people going about their daily business in Congo. When you got off the main road, this road was a very sandy road, and it made the car jump up and down. I mean, really big time, like you're on a ride at a theme park, you know, going up and down. And so it was bouncing us around so much that Mushi and I just began to laugh, you know, because it seemed so funny that we were on this road. But this is how a lot of the roads are. When you get off the main road, some are like that, some are different, but you're gonna see a variety here. Thank you. again, and here we're about to go into a school where my church had been partnering with the school in Congo called ARD. They train adults and young adults in different skills, computer, construction, hair design, all kinds of different skills. And so they were taking us on our very first day that we came. They took us into to see the school, and you'll see different scenes of the classes, but then you're gonna actually be taken to a live ceremony where they were graduating students who were in a class that was training people how to do wedding planning. And so what they do, they actually bring a person who they will adorn like a bride. So the person graduating has to bring someone that they fixed up as if she was getting married and present, and there's judges there that will judge everything, and then the people graduate. Family was there, people were excited, and it was an amazing experience. So enjoy this. There was an amazing moment when we were waiting inside to go somewhere, and the director of the school walked in the room where we were. And as you see, you're gonna see in the picture coming, he had the same shirt that I had on, except he's a few sizes smaller than me. And he walked in and we looked at each other, we're like, wait a minute. And it was the same brand. I mean, the pocket, everything was exactly the same. Now, I'm coming from the USA, he's there in Congo, and we couldn't figure it out, and we were just laughing, and it was like a great unifying moment. You know, me coming from representing the church, you know, that we support them, and then him having that same shirt on. And we found out later, someone that came from the USA a few months earlier brought him that shirt, and we found out they bought it from Ross Stores, and that's where I bought mine from. And so that's how he had it, and he happened to wear it that day that I was wearing mine, and it was really an amazing moment. traveled around, and as you see, Moshiach was doing some cooking where we were, and then we visited family. We have a big family in Congo, and it was really amazing to see them, to spend time with them, my nieces, and then other family members. It was great. This trip had a lot of fun included, and there was also a greater purpose in which we went, and this was to visit some churches where I actually preached them.
But Jesus is glorified right here in Congo. Amen. Let's praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, maybe there is someone here that is not sure that they are born again. Maybe someone even went to church for many years, but they're not sure if they really know Jesus. And even in this day we are living in,
même si nous vivons dans l'époque
aujourd'hui, oftentimes the churches come into this spiritual condition.
Église peut et comment on fait dans le lendemain au cancer par rapport à l'église à l'ouvrage de la
Bible. Amen.
So he said unto the pastor of the church of the Laodicean.
Et alors il écrit à l'ange de l'église de Laodicée.
I want you to write these things.
Voici ce que dit l'amen.
So this was written to the church.
Mais oh, ils avaient écrit pour comme à l'église.
So let's go down a little bit to verse 20.
Et donc, il a marqué dans verset 20.
In this letter, Jesus said many things.
Et dans mon canal, oh, Jésus m'a dit, alors, il m'a comme révélé.
But he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock.
Alors, il voici, je me tiens à la porte et je frappe.
So, the question is, why was Jesus standing at the door of the church?
Question, alors, pourquoi Jésus m'a dit, à telle minute, c'est ma porte.
Jesus ordained the church. Jesus started the church. Just like God started the priesthood under Moses. But we see the condition of the church that he's writing to. After many years gone by, something happened to the church.
Amen.
Now Jesus is saying, hey, I'm knocking at the door. He said, if any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in.
Amen.
And will sup with him and
he will avec lui et lui avec moi.
Amen.
Amen. We'll be right back.